Corruption is everywhere. Everything is happening. So we don't have faith. Actually, corruption has brought our country to such a wide, it's made such a wide image of unfaithfulness. Yes, we feel scared. But in our constitution it is written, we are all equal and safe. So, there are several people who are working to see that people are treated with dignity and as equals. During this corona, again another example, during this corona, lakhs of people, thousands of people were traveling. I've heard on the radio in Muzaffarpur, such wonderful people are there, those who have been giving food to poor people, not waiting for the government, taking care of them, standing on the road and giving them food. These guys who are working in the hospitals, you know, these fighters, I listen on the radio. They are not scared. The police, the woman police in Bihar, the woman police of Muzaffarpur, they are going out trying to keep the locality in proper condition so that this does not spread. They have forgotten about their own lives. They are out on the streets. The doctors, the helpers, but we don't listen. See, they are making sure that people are safe. They are not saying, hey, you are this caste, okay. No, let corona catch you. No. Equal. But after the corona, we are saying, when a patient is coming back, I say, oh, this is corona. Hey, get out, we won't let you come inside. This is bad. Discriminating. Unjust. Examples I am giving. The law is there to protect you. I had told you, even children have got rights. But we must know the way to take care of our rights from the right disciplined manner. This recognition actually of equality includes some of the following provisions in the Constitution. Every person is equal before the law. What this means is that every person, from the president of the country to our Lakshmi Bai or our Meena Bai or our Susila aunty or whatever names, means our domestic worker, has to obey the same laws from the president to the last down person. Second, no person can be discriminated against anybody on the basis of the religion, race, caste, place of birth, or whether they are male or female. Third, every person has access to all public places, including playgrounds, hotels, shops, and markets. All people can use public available wells for water, roads and bathing ghats to have baths. Fourth, untouchability has been abolished. Don't touch me. You can go and have a bath. If people are having bath in a public place, you can have a public bath. Okay. You can go to any market, you can go to any hotel, you can go to any playground, you can go to any shop, you can go to any restaurant. No one will stop you. But that doesn't mean I wear a Bermuda or a pair of boxers and a sleeveless t-shirt and go into a 5-star hotel to eat food. There is a dress code, right? I can wear a Bermuda and a vest in a 5-star hotel and sit at the poolside and have my food or breakfast or my drinks or have a party with my that type of clothes is allowed at that place. But generally, yes, if I wear a pair of jeans, if I'm wearing a sleeveless t-shirt, I'm well dressed, my shoes are okay, then I don't go with slippers on, plop, 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 plop inside the restaurant to eat food. Right? So, but these days it happens. People are becoming more normal. But there are certain places where rules have to be maintained. Discipline. The two ways in which the government has tried to implement the equality, okay, that is guaranteed in the constitution, is first through laws, second through government programs or schemes to help disadvantaged communities. There are several laws in India that protect every person's right to be treated equally. In plus to the laws, the government has also, the law has got nothing to do, the government follows the laws, has set up several schemes to improve the lives of communities and individuals who have been treated unequally for several centuries. These schemes are to ensure greater opportunity, greater help for people who have not got this help in the past. Midday meal has started in schools. They provide children with cooked lunch. Tamil Nadu was the first state in India to introduce this scheme in 2001. Then Supreme Court asked all the state governments to begin this program in their schools within 6 months. This program has got many positive effects. This includes that so many poor children have begun enrolling regularly, attending school just because of that food they are coming to school. What used to happen, children used to come to school, go for lunch home and not come back. But now attendance has improved. Now mothers also, those who work outside, those who are working on the field, they don't have to come home to feed their children. They know that food is there. This has helped to stop caste prejudice, religion prejudice. Both lower caste and upper caste children in the school eat food together. In few places, Dalit people are cooking. It has helped to reduce the hunger of poor children who cannot concentrate on studies because of hunger. There are so many things. Do you know one thing? I remember of our late APG Abdul Kalam. He used to sell newspapers. He became the president of India. Yesterday or something, I was reading a news. A girl's father sells newspapers. She's become a topper. And she wants to change the education system. I don't know from which state. Beautiful, lovely girl, smart. Does her face or does her report card say that her father sells paper, she cannot become the topper? Father sells papers on a cycle. APJ Abdul Kalam also sold news. He started selling news, he became the news. Today that little girl of 16 years or 17 years old, whatever she is, today she's been a topper in the CBSE or class 12. I was hearing the radio. I like to hear a lot. She stopped it. But can we say, no. The person who was checking her paper, if would have come to know that father is a cycle, was delivering papers on the cycle, no, she cannot get so many marks. This is prejudice, this is discrimination. But she stopped it. Now she is wanting to change the education system for girls. Imagine that Josh. That's what you are. You are the future. This will actually prove that what is in the constitution. You will prove what is happening is actually it says in the constitution that it exists, it does not actually exist in the society, but it is, you will change the system. See you in the next class again, and then we'll start reading. I don't actually touch the book before I explain. I like explaining first and sharing whatever information I have. Democracy in Action, Universal Adult Franchise, have the right to vote, all women and men. And then we have elections, secret ballot, simple majority system, constituency, but we have to learn much more about it, election campaign. We'll do that in the next chapter. I just wanted to give you the brief information about a democracy in action. Next class we'll do that. See you guys. Take care and love your family and respect your family. Parents, listen to them and do whatever you want after your studies. Bye bye.